Shalom ubracha. I would like to wish to all of you happiness, health, and Be'ezat Hashem, a good week. The parasha of this week is the parasha of MIshpatim. MIshpatim, that means this is the laws that Hashem gave to the Bnei Israel after they received the Torah. Last week it was the parasha of Matan Torah, the parasha of the Ten Commandments, and now it's the MIshpatim. Now Hashem will give the laws to the Bnei Israel. Next week is the parasha of Teruma, the parasha that Hashem asked the Bnei Israel, the Jews, to build a house, like a Beit HaMikdash, a house of Hashem. But first, my friend, this parasha, we do not understand why this parasha starts, this is the laws. Why the Torah will not start? This is the Torah that every Jew should study Torah. I think for me, the first mitzvah that Hashem should give to the Jewish people is to study Torah. Be'agitabo yomam v'alayla. Like the angel said to Yeshua ben Nun, you have to study Torah day and night. Why the Torah don't start by studying Torah? That you have to study Torah. After Matan Torah, the first law should be, you have to study Torah. But in this parasha, the parasha starts about something else. If somebody steal money from somebody and he has no money to give back what he stole, or if somebody made a big loan and he don't have money to pay his loan, so what can we do? What can he do? So the Torah said, so the one who lent him the money, the Beit Din, the rabbis, they can put a contract that this man who steal the money, or this man that he have no money to give back to the one who lend him money, so he become his slave. Well, today there is no such a mitzvah today. Today there is no slaves today. Today but at that time it was at that time. Don't remember only a few hundred years ago, that the Americans stopped, you know, making business with slaves. You remember? It was a big civil war in America. A few hundred years ago, you know, it was a big business of selling people, slaves. You know, today things change. But at that time, that was a big business to buy a slave. You buy a family, and you have a family who serve you. You remember, you know, the whole story is there is a story in Rome, the revolution of the slaves. The slaves, they made a revolution in Rome and they burned Rome. So at the time, there was a big, big, big business of slaves. It was like normal. And because at that time it was like normal, so the Torah starts this parasha of this week, if you buy a slave, you cannot buy the slave forever. You can buy it only for 6 years, no more. And after 6 years, you give him his freedom. And when you give him this freedom, you're not allowed to throw him away. You have to give him money. And you have to know something. Being a slave by a Jew is not easy. The Torah said, if you buy a slave, you have to remember, if you had one portion of food and there is you and your slave, who eats first? So the Torah said, the one who eats first is the slave. That means if you have one bed and there is you and your slave, who take the bed? You go to a hotel with your slave because he serves you, and there is only one bedroom. Who is sleeping in the bed? Your slave, not you. That means the Torah gives you an impression that you have a slave, but you don't have a slave. You have a boss, because always we give the priority of to the slave. You know, we learn a lot of things that the Torah, she teaches us, don't forget you've been slaves in Egypt. You know what it is hard to be a slave. Like the Eben Ezra said, anyone who is a slave is very, very bad for a man that he has another man that he controls him. It's very, very hard to be a slave to somebody. So that's why the Torah warns you, don't forget, don't be cruel to your slave. If you buy a slave, you have to be nice to him. Like other nation that they don't behave, for them a slave is a slave and that's it. No. You buy a slave, you buy a boss. So you understand, it's not so easy. Don't think that by buying a slave, you bought something that you can do with him whatever you want to do. No, there is special halachot. There is special laws about what it is a slave. So my friend, why the Torah, after Matan Torah, start where with this mitzvah, if you buy a slave? Especially, this mitzvah today, it's not useful. Today there is no slave. I mean, the Torah should start with a mitzvah that like Kriyat Shema, that putting tefillin, doing Brit Milah. There is some mitzvot, eating kosher. There is mitzvot that we have to do them all the time. But why the Torah, after that we talk about Matan Torah, the Torah talk about if you buy a slave. Okay, if you buy a slave. I mean, this mitzvah will not last forever. It lasts only a few hundred years. So the Torah should start with something that, like you have to study Torah, or something, I think for me, the main thing of a Jew is to study Torah. Because by studying Torah, you will do Halimud Mivele Demaase. By studying Torah, you will do all the mitzvot. So I think for me, after Matan Torah, after the Naish of the Torah should start with, you have to study Torah. It's a mitzvah to study Torah. Zot Chokat HaTorah, B'Dibat Abam. I mean, you have to study, you have to teach your children. Now, the Torah starts if you buy a slave. And this is Ela MIshpatim. This is the laws that Hashem said to Moshe. Those laws, you have to put them, you have to explain them very, 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 very well to the Jewish people. The Rashi said, like a Shulchan Aruch. What that means like a Shulchan Aruch? It's like when you have a guest, you must put everything near him. I mean, can you imagine? You invite somebody and he's sitting, there is no plate. Or there is a plate, but there is no knife, no fork. Or there is no bread, or there is no serviette. I mean, when you have a guest, you have to put everything near him so he's not embarrassed. Because usually when you have guests, they are a little bit embarrassed. So that he will not be embarrassed, put everything near him. That's what Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe, you have to put the Torah like a Shulchan Aruch. You have to explain them. And don't say that he understands. Maybe he did not understand. Maybe he shines. So repeat and repeat and repeat till he understands. I mean, you have to know one thing. The Arizal HaKadosh said, the same way that without food we cannot live, so you have to know, without Torah we cannot live. Is that our direction is the Torah. We live according to the Torah. So it's very important that we should know that without Torah, I mean, we did not come to this world just to eat, to get married, to have a house, just to enjoy holiday, vacation, cars. No, there is something else. To serve Hashem, to be His slave. This is very important for you to know. This is very important for you to know that this world is not abandoned. This world, it's, you have some direction to do. There is something that you have to do. Of course you have to eat. Of course you have to, you can enjoy your life. No problem. But your soul needs food. The body, he needs food, so give him food to eat, water to drink. But don't forget, your soul as well needs food. What kind of food you can give to your soul, your neshama, is the Torah. I think, my friend, this is the meaning. Ele HaMishpatim Asher Tashim Lifnei. This is the laws that you have to put, to propose them, and put it on the table that you will understand it. The same way that without food, if you don't put near your guest everything around him, he will be shy. The same way, when it comes to Torah, Hashem seems to have to explain him the Torah in a way that he will understand it, because sometimes he may be shy to ask you, I did not understand, because not everybody understands the same way. There's people that you have to repeat once, there is people that you have to repeat twice, there is people that you have to repeat a lot of times. The Gemara said, Rab Frida, one big rabbi, he has one student. And that student, he don't understand right away. He had to repeat him 400 times. 400 times. And after 400 times, he understand. One day, Rab Frida was repeating, till he arrived to 400 times less one. That means 399 times. And there, Rab Frida, he had to stand up because somebody called him, and he went. When he came back, Rab Frida, he told him, I did repeat you the lesson 399. We have another time to repeat. And he told him, the student, I forgot. Because when he stopped, I forgot. And Rab Frida, he could tell him, get out from here. Do you think I'm a donk? Just to repeat. No. Rab Frida, he took a lot of patience. And he started to repeat to him another 400 times. And there was a voice from the Shamaim who said, Rab Frida, for the patience that you had with your student, all your generation will have Olam Haba. Do you all have? Can you imagine, my friend, how much you have to be patient when you teach Torah to somebody? And that this is what the Torah means. Ele HaMishpatim Asher Tashim Lifnei. You have, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, when you teach the Torah to the Bnei Israel, you have to put it in a way like, and you have to serve the Torah in a way that they will understand 100% what you teach them. like the example I said, like when you have a guest, that you have to put everything around him so he will not be shy to ask for something. And there is a mitzvah as well that you have to ask your guest, do you want more? In my house, even when he said no, I give him more. Because I said maybe he's a shy. I prefer to give him more than not to give him and he's still starving. My friend, this is the reason I think why the Torah, after Matan Torah, the Torah starts with this parasha of slaves. And you know, as I said, I told you before, the parasha of slaves, it happened only a few hundred years ago. Today we don't need it. So why the Torah start with something that the Torah knows that it will stop? The same question. Next week is the parasha of to build Beit HaMikdash. I mean, even for that, we don't need, because the Beit HaMikdash, it did not last only a few hundred years. So why the Torah talks so much about the Beit HaMikdash? You have to know something, my friend. The Torah, she wants to give us to know the importance of each mitzvah that Hashem give us. Even mitzvot that really, they will last only a few years. And after, we will not need them. Like how to build the Beit HaMikdash, like all the mitzvot that rely the slaves. We don't need to do this. Why do Torah talk about them? But Hashem, he wants you to know. Not only mitzvot that you have to do all years till Mashiach will come. Those are very important in the eyes of Hashem. Hashem wants to teach us even the mitzvot that they will not last forever. For the time being that we have to do them, they have a big importance. Because people may say, well, I don't need to respect a lot the mitzvah of if I buy a slave. Because anyway, after this mitzvah will be cancelled. Okay, even for the Beit HaMikdash, I don't need to do to build the Beit HaMikdash the same way that Hashem, he wants us to build it anyway. The Beit HaMikdash, one day will be destroyed. Now, Hashem, after Matan Torah, he give so much importance to the mitzvot, even those mitzvot, that only for the time being you have to respect them. It's very important because Pikudei Hashem Emet, MIshpatim Hashem Tzadku Yahdav. The laws of Hashem, we have to respect them. Hashem knows why he gives them. So it's not you to decide, well, because they will be postponed, they will be cancelled one day, well, it doesn't matter. No. For the time being that they exist, you have to respect them very, very well. Look, after Matan Torah, the Torah asks that we have to build a mezbeah with stones. Mezbeah is the hotel of sacrifice. And that hotel of sacrifice, we need it only when there was the Beit HaMikdash. I mean, I don't understand why the Torah talk about the Mizbeah after Matan Torah. Why the Torah will not talk about something else? But exactly. The Torah wants to teach us. Not because those mitzvot that I give you, like Mizbeah, like the mitzvah of Avadim, like the mitzvah of to build Beit HaMikdash, those mitzvot are so important, but only they are important for a time being. That's it. Not forever. Well, I can reduce, I can do whatever I want. No. But Hashem wants to teach you. That's why the Torah, she did not start, you have to study Torah. No, because the Torah, she knows that the word was created to study Torah. It's not a big deal that the Torah would tell you, you have to study Torah. No. Everyone knows already. I mean, it's normal when a baby, the more he grows, he knows that his father, he has to call him Papa. You know who is his father. His father, he doesn't need to tell him every day, I am your father. No, the baby knows already who is his father. So, when Hashem, he gives the Torah to the Bnei Israel, he did not tell them, it's me Hashem who created the world. No, because eventually, everybody knows that Hashem created the world. They had a lot of proof with all what they saw in Egypt. So Hashem didn't need to tell them that. Or what Hashem told them, there are things he did for them. What he did for them, I'm Hashem who brought you out from Egypt. That's it. Why I brought you out from Egypt? To give you the Torah. Yeah, so that's why the Torah don't start with, you have to study the Torah, because eventually they know. Every Jew knows the reason why Hashem chose them, why Hashem he bring them out of Egypt, why Hashem did all the miracles to them, to give them the Torah, and to study the Torah, that's it. So that's why the Torah don't start about a big mitzvot, after Matan Torah. Torah start with mitzvot that one day they're going to be postponed. They will be cancelled. Like when the temple will be destroyed, there will be no business of slaves, there will be no mizbeah. But those mitzvot are very important for the time that you have to respect them. That's why the Torah starts with this mitzvot. Well, my friend, from here I understand something else and finish. From here I understand how much you have to be very careful with the mitzvot that they are very small. People usually don't want to do big mitzvot, and they don't take care about the small mitzvot. So a man should think, if Hashem starts after the Matan Torah to tell the Jews to respect the mitzvot that they're going to be postponed, but for the time being that those mitzvot exist, you have to respect them, so kal vachomer, that mitzvot that we have to do them all the time and they are small, that we have to do them. My friend, I would like to wish to all of you happiness, bracha, v'atzlacha. Let's pray to Hashem that we will do all what Hashem wants from us. Hashem bless you. Thank you.